has kept us. Let's go ahead and appreciate him. Once again, I welcome you to Church Online Sunday, the 6th of December, year 2020. I want you to go ahead and say, Father, I thank you. I appreciate you. I give you glory. I give you worship in the name of Jesus. Oh, Daddy, I appreciate you. I'm grateful. Thank you for another opportunity to be in your presence, even on this church online. We appreciate you, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Daddy, we bless you. We are thankful. We are grateful. Glory, glory, glory be to your name, in the name of Jesus. I want you to go ahead and say, Daddy, the year 2020 is running to an end. Let me end it well. Let it be well with me. Let me end it well, in the mighty name of Jesus. Whatever plans the evil ones may have concerning me and my household, let it be destroyed by the fire of God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, blessed Father. Glory be to your holy name. In Jesus' mighty, mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Amen. Amen in Jesus' name. Once again, I want to welcome every one of you, brothers and sisters, bishops, ministers of the gospel. Do us a favor by sharing this broadcast. And let's even know that you are there. I want your comment, your amen. Let's know you are part of this broadcast this morning. It's going to be a very short one, but very, very deep. And the topic is actually prophetic. And I want you to get this, brothers and sisters. Anytime you see an apostle of Jehovah, anytime you see a prophet of God come to you in this dimension, in this kind of topic, I want you to know that it's not ordinary. There is a purpose for it. The topic today is, no evil shall befall thee. No evil shall befall thee. I want somebody to type that with his own hand. In fact, wherever you are listening to me from, say it with your mouth. No evil shall befall me. And if it is possible for you to type, that's if you are not driving, maybe you are enjoying this from the comfort of your home. Type it with your own hand. Because that which you say, that which you type, listen, is going to be accomplished in your life. Type it, no evil shall befall me. This time I don't put D. That's the topic. You can see that it's already pinned down there. No evil shall befall thee. But when you are typing it, say, no evil shall befall me. And before I teach this word, hear me. I turn it to prayer concerning you. And I prophesy in the name that is above every other name, in the mighty name of Jesus, whether anybody likes it or not, whether any power likes it or not, listen, even if your own life do not require it, for the fact that you are having this encounter with this word of God, I prophesy concerning you, as the year is running to an end, the year 2020, even beyond it, no evil shall befall you in the name of Jesus. No evil shall befall you in the name of Jesus. I say it one more time. In the name of Jesus, no evil whatsoever it is that can be termed to be evil, that can be referred to as evil, it shall not come to your dwelling place. It shall not come to your dwelling place. In the mighty name of Jesus, it shall not befall you. In the mighty name of Jesus. And so shall it be. As you have said amen with your mouth, as you have typed amen, I say it one more time, so shall it be for you. Evil will not know your abode. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. And let the people say amen. All right. No evil shall befall you. That's the teaching this morning. I said to you, it's prophetic. It's apostolic. And I'm glad. I'm glad because it's coming at the right time. This topic is coming at the right season. Why? We are in December 2020. The year is running to an end. A lot of people have had this erroneous belief that when we are in this, in the month of December, when the year is running to an end, there are a lot of evil things happen. Of course, evil happens not in December alone. Evil happens in January. It can happen in any month of the year at any time. But because you are here, as for you and your household, I decree, for somebody who can say amen loudly and clearly where you are listening from, or that can even type in amen, I decree, no evil shall befall you in the name of Jesus. Thank you, great Dustin, my big brother. Be your mercy and God bless you for joining us. You are welcome on board. No evil shall befall you and your household, sir. In the name of Jesus. All right. So I want to admit, let's type this fast this morning. We're not going to read too much scripture, but I want your hearts to be open. Psalm 91, verse 10. That is our scripture. Popular scripture, but we have to dissect it this morning. We have to understand it this morning. Psalm 91, verse number 10. Psalm 91 and verse 10. Let's have it there. That's it. God bless you. Psalm 91, verse 10. And I'm going to read the scripture from here. Psalm 91, verse 10. I will read it both in English language and in Yoruba. You can read it in any version of the Bible, wherever you are. But I would love it that you will open it if it's possible. And you read it, even as I read it from here. No evil shall befall thee. And our text is taken from Psalm 91 and verse 10. I read. The Bible says in Psalm 91, verse 10. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come near your dwelling place. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. In Yoruba version, the Bible says, buburu kan, not even one, buburu kan koni shubuluo, beni arun karun ki yo sumo ile re. I read it one more time in English. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling place. This is God's word, brothers and sisters. This is not my word. I want somebody's heart to open this morning. Oro to n gbo isa woli kankan lo so be sinu aye re o. God bless you, great of mercy and Olumi Dustin. God bless you, sir. This is not the word of a prophet. This is not the word of an apostle. This is not a proclamation from a general overseer, sir. The Bible says, there shall be no evil that will befall thee. I declare upon you, you and your household, in the name of Jesus, no evil will befall thee. No evil will befall thee. No evil will befall thee. Buburuko ni shubuluo. Ani buburuko ni shubuluo. Moni buburuko ni shubuluo. In the name of Jesus. I don't want you to just watch this program this morning. I want you to be receiving this. But we are going somewhere. Sir, this is God's word. This is the scripture. But do you know, there is a question you need to quickly ask yourself. And I believe I'm talking to intelligent people this morning. I am not a minister of the gospel who wants to teach people who will dump their brain, their mind. You must reason along with me. Challenge the words if it's possible. If you have superior arguments, bring it on board. Hallelujah. This is God's word. But because I know you are intelligent, I've gone ahead to ask a question that I think every intelligent person should be asking in their heart. And what is that question? Why will this word come? No evil shall befall you. And that is God's word. And it will be so for you, sir. It will be so for you, ma'am. Mommy Balabo, God bless you. It will be so for you. It will be so. No evil will befall you, ma'am. Bishop, no evil will befall you. Man, listen, how or why will evil not befall you? Kilo de, kilo shele, ti buburama shele ka kiriti odeni le shele siye. Why will evil be happening? I told you, brothers and sisters, a lot of people believe that evil happens most of the time or mostly in December. And I've refuted that. I just told you, evil can happen any time of the year. There can be, if I've had people had accidents 1st of January and they died. Catastrophic accident, evil, bad things happen anytime, at any time in the any month of the year. But I'm asking a question this morning. The scripture says in Psalm 91 verse 10, evil will not befall you. No plague will come to your dwelling place. So why will evil be happening all over the place? Why will plagues be taking over the nations of the world? Even your streets, your country, your local council, your local government, where you dwell around you, and it will not come to your dwelling place. It will not appear to have seen you. It will look as if you have immunity. Ada ben pe ko ti e ri e o ti e si laye ka be. Meanwhile o de wa laye ka ibiyen, o wa laye ka ajakale arun yen, sugbon ko sele si e. Ko de ni sele si e loruko Jesu. I say it won't happen to you. Even won't happen to you. Plagues won't come to your dwelling place in the name of Jesus. Amen. Somebody did not say amen to that. And somebody did not type in amen. Now, the question is, how or why will evil be happening and it won't happen to you? Excuse me, sir. Very simple. That is why you need to open your heart to this teaching. You need to understand why this evil will be happening and it will not happen to you. Ogbodo ni oye pe ibi mama sele ko de ni sele si mi. Ajakale arun mama ajakiri sugbon ko ni de ibi ti mo gbe. Ai, this is sweet to hear. It's not a big secret, but before I show this to you, I want to prophesy and I want to decree by apostolic unction upon everyone that have joined me this morning on this church online, on this Gospel Response Ministries page, starting from my elder brother, Brother B. Your Moshen, to Bishop, to Pastor, to Reverend, to Olusho, to Manabe, to Mojisola, to Sister Fumi, to Baker, I can't get that name very well, hallelujah, to Mommy Bolahan, I pray for every one of you, to Steve, to Ken, hallelujah, I pray for Golabo, every one of you, I decree to Abedo Dujiri, to Precious, to Prophet Yemi, oh, to Apostle Adeniji, God bless you, sir. Every one of you, and even those of you that I'm sorry if I have not mentioned your name, as many as are online this morning, hear me clearly. Authoritatively, in the name of Jesus, I decree, not for this December alone, the entirety of your life, evil will not befall you. Evil will not befall you. Oh, Shami, evil will not befall you. Plagues will not come to your dwelling place. I say evil will not befall you. Evil will not befall you. In the name of Jesus. Evil will not befall you. Evil will not befall you. Ibu buruko ni subulwe. Ibi oni bae. Ankaro ni mwebito ngbe. Evil will not befall you. So shall it be. This that I have said, it will be upheld by heaven. Heaven will uphold it. It will stand. It will not fall to the ground. In the name of Jesus, Baba ri eyan kan to da be ni pe ibi ti subulu. Ayayayaya. In case there is someone that it appears that evil has already befallen you by virtue of encounter with the name of Jesus, I pronounce, come out of that evil in the name of Jesus. I speak to your life. Mo ba aye re soro. Ko jade kuro ninu ibi yen, ko jade kuro ninu ajakale arun yen, in the name of Jesus, every evil surrounding your life, let your life escape them. The Bible says he will make you to escape. He will make a way of escape for you. Your life is escaping. Your life has escaped in Jesus' name. Amen. Let me show you too. God bless you too, my brother. How much I be. God bless you, sir. Now listen to me. We've read that scripture, Psalm 91 verse 10. The Bible says, evil will not befall you. And that's the topic. And I told you, this topic came at the right time. We're in December. That mentality, which is wrong, that evil is always multiplied in December. Maybe it has been happening. Maybe that's why people have that erroneous belief. But I've told you, evil can happen in any month of the year. But let us even assume that mentality in people's head is correct. That evil happens regularly. The Bible says in Psalm 91 verse 10, there shall be no evil that will befall thee, and no pestilence will come to your dwelling place. And the topic today is, no evil shall befall thee. And I ask a question. How will this be? Bawo lo se ma ri be ti bi mama sele kakiri Why will it be that evil will be happening everywhere and it will not come to your dwelling place? Very simple secret, sir. The same book of Psalm 91. Somebody to type that on the screen for me. Psalm 91, verse 1 and verse 9. Psalm number 91, the same book of Psalm 91, verse 1 and verse 1 and verse 9. Ese kini ati ese kesan. Psalm 91, verse 1 and verse 9. I will read it from here. And I want you to carry your Bible if you have it. If you don't have it with you, just listen. I will read it clearly to you. Psalm 91, verse 1 says, "He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty." And God has a secret place. I'm going to show it to you in a moment. Those that dwell in the secret place of the Most High. And to be koko ga ogo. Ongbe ni secret place. And to gaju. Kali mayada. The Bible says that person will abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Verse 9. The Bible says in verse 9, "Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, you have made him your habitation." Only ni tori pe iwo Oluwa o ti fi Oluwa se bi abo re ibi pamọ re o fi Oluwa se ibi ibugbe re. You have made him your dwelling place, secret place. Excuse me, sir. The open secret of you living without any evil befalling you is very simple. You must be able to live in the secret place of the Most High. As a matter of fact, I always tell people, there are some scriptures. Listen, Egboro, yo, there are some scriptures in the Bible. They will never be true. And they are not true unless you understand on which other scripture they depend upon. Eni kama shimibo, awon oro kan wa ninu bibeli ko ni je otito ki si se otito. Reason ni pe otito ni won sugbon won le da duro. Those words cannot stand alone. They always stand on something. They depend on other scripture for them to be true. A good example is the scripture for today, where we pick our topic, "No evil shall befall thee." Psalm 91 verse 10 is a scripture that has never stood in the Koledadro. It can't stand alone. It cannot. It depends on this verse 1 and verse 9. The Bible says in that verse 10 that we read, that no evil shall befall you. Why? Because you have chosen to dwell, to live in the secret place of the Almighty. You have made God your habitation, your place of abode. Do you know what I did, sir? Because I want you to have understanding, I did research and I understood something. The Greek word that was translated in verse 1 of that Psalm 91 to be secret place simply was shelter, high towers. And the Egyptians in those days, you know, the early civilization, they had this thing physically. They will build high towers. Those days, somebody will not be on top of the high tower. When enemies were coming, the person will be the one to ring the gong. Then the king will summon the armies of the land. That ati luago, the alarm is sounding. That means an enemy is coming. They will see the enemy far away. Hallelujah. So the secret place is just, that time was physical towers. You know, structures. Heavy structure that even when you shoot gun at it, it won't penetrate the walls. You see those walls, then the very thick walls are high. You know, that's actually the Greek, the meaning of the original Greek word that was translated as secret place. It simply means a place of shelter, high towers, physical towers, a home, a building of protection that has tall building, high building where you can run to. And then you are safe. But when the guns are flying, the bullets are flying, you run into that building. In those days, when the person that is standing on top of the tower rings the bell, everybody runs into that home, into that tower, into that high tower, that Ivory Coast tower. And then everybody is secured. Everybody is safe. It's called, it's not even war. They call it shelter. I mean, United Kingdom has it now in places. I've even visited one in the United Kingdom before. You know, that one was even underground. But it's deep, you know. It's called shelter. Now, do you understand that foundation? And the Bible says you have to be living in this kind of shelter for you to be able to be sure or say or affirm Psalm 91 verse 10 upon your life. But all of us talk about me here, it be on, it by, evil will not come to your place. But you must dwell in my shelter. You must dwell in my tower. And then I began to say, what is that tower? What is that shelter that God is talking about that you need to dwell in so that your life will not be in danger, so that you will not experience the danger that is coming? Listen to me. That shelter is actually the shelter of Jehovah Elion. That shelter, that's why the Jerusalem Bible call it the shelter of Elion. The Jerusalem Bible also call it the shadow of El Shaddai. The shadow of El Shaddai, it will become a cover, a protection. Hallelujah. But the question is this: what is that secret place that you need to now dwell in? What is that shelter that you need to run to, and then you will be safe? Kini bi kokoga ogo, kini bi pamo nyesin. Where is that physical shelter that you need to run to for evil not to befall you? I will show it to you, and then we pray for 2 minutes. Hallelujah. Very simple. The answer is in Proverbs chapter 18, verse 10. Somebody type that in for us. Proverbs chapter 18. Proverbs chapter 18 and verse number 10. Proverbs chapter 18. And verse number 10. I think somebody is typing that in. Proverbs chapter 18 and verse 10. I will read it from here. Proverbs 18 verse 10. I want you to listen to this. This will blow up your mind, but it is the truth. Very simple truth. Proverbs chapter 18 verse 10. Hear it clearly. The Bible says, the name of the Lord. Don't forget I told you about the strong tower. The shelter. The shelter of Elion. The shadow of the El Shaddai himself. The Bible says in Proverbs chapter 18 verse 10. The name of the Lord is a strong tower. That is the tower, sir. And what happened? The Bible says the righteous run into it. And what happened? They are safe. Oruko luwa ile ishura barani olododo sawo beosiye. My brothers and sisters, this is the simplest thing you have ever heard. Very straightforward and simple. You become secure. You can affirm Psalm 91 verse 10 to yourself when you run into the shelter of the Most High. What is that secret place? The Bible says the name of the Lord, Orukolua. That is your secret place. That is your dwelling place. That is my dwelling place. Don't forget, sir. We wrestle not against principalities. We wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and power. You can find that in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12. We wrestle against powers, against principalities, against rulers of the kingdom of darkness, against spiritual wickedness. I'm telling you, sir, both day and night, arrow, sir, these powers that be rulers of the kingdom of darkness, powers that be, the Bible says those are the kind of people we contend with, and they exist in our world. But the Bible says in that Proverbs 18:10, the name of God is our own strong tower that we need to dwell in, that we need to run into so that we can be saved. After running to the name of God, you can affirm Psalm 91 verse 10 to yourself. Because as at that time, you are now living in the secret place of the Most High. Are you living in the secret place of God? The secret place of God is his name. The Bible says the name of God is the strong tower. I told you that El Shaddai, that shadow of El Shaddai, that shelter of El Leon is the tower, the high towers. And the Bible says in Proverbs 18:10 that the name of God is this strong tower that we are talking about. That you run into it and you will be saved. You will be secured from the pestilence of the day, from the arrows that fly by night or by day, because that name will keep you secured. No wonder the Bible says in John chapter 1 verse 12, John chapter 1, verse 12. The Bible says that he came to his own. His own refused. They didn't receive him. They received him not. But those that received him, I'm talking about John chapter 1, verse 12. John 1, 12. He gave them power. Power to do what? Power to become the sons and the daughters of God. Of one year, bara, lati shekini, lati di omo lorun. Egbo misha. So, rito bati ni Jesu se, okon be, be a ye oshi. Igbe a ye asen, biti mon lorun ye. You have not had Jesus in your life. You've not received him as your Lord and Savior. You are just living a miserable life. Even when your life appears to be painted good, it's not good. You are just being orchestrated for destruction. Egbo mi sa, oni ojo eyin to ti koja to le pada lomo. You have your years, your life in the past that you cannot go back to correct. The life that your forefathers lived, your forefathers, your ancient fathers, you can't go back to correct the evils that they have done. The occultic covenant that they have made with your life, with their generations. You need somebody who can go back there and do correction. And the only one is Arugbu Ojo. The only one that can visit that foundation is Arugbu Ojo. You need Christ in your life. You have the present moment that you cannot even understand, you can't take control of. Listen to me. The one that can handle it is Jesus. You have a tomorrow that you don't know anything about. You don't know what has been planted into that tomorrow. There is somebody who can go into your tomorrow and make things normal even before you get to your tomorrow. His name is Jesus. The Bible says, no evil shall befall thee. But for this to come to pass, you must live in the secret place of the Most High. And the secret place of the Most High is his name. I bring to you this morning, brothers and sisters, those who have not accepted Jesus as their Lord and Savior. It is time to accept him as your Lord and as your Savior. And you don't want me, you will be glad you did this morning. And for those of us that have had Jesus as our Lord and Savior, you have already accepted him as your Lord and Savior. You already dwell in that name, in that pavilion. You already dwelling in that tower. Then go ahead and pray with me. Say, El Shaddai, I cry to you this day, let no evil befall me, even as year 2020 is going to an end. Open your mouth and begin to pray in the name of Jesus. Any come, bummy. Toba mo ekpe, iwo ti ni orukon ye already. O mo ekpe, o pelu awon ti, o ti yege to ti wa ninu Jesu. O ti mo so fun ere sa. Pariwo, El Shaddai, I cry to you this day, mo kigbe pe ode ojo toni. Let no evil befall me in the mighty name of Jesus. Ma je ki bi kankan ko ba mi Olorun. Ma se je ki bi kankan ko ba mi. Eni kan o soro. Say, Lord, let no evil befall me in the mighty name of Jesus. Let no evil befall me. Admin, let's try to post that these prayer points on the screen so that men and brethren can always use it. That's it on the screen. In the name of Jesus, those are the prayer points. Say, El Shaddai. You can see it's already there now. It's there on your screen. Say, El Shaddai, I cry to you this day. Let no evil befall me. Ma je ki bi kan koko ba mi. Even bi odun 2020. Bo se pari lo. Oluwa shabole mi lori se. Ma je ki bi ko ba mi. Baba ma se je ki bi ko ba mi. Say, Lord, let no evil befall me. In the name of Jesus. Let no evil befall me. Oh, let no evil befall me. In Kalebo Sotalia. And I want you to go ahead and pray the number two. You see, just four prayer points on your screen now. By Jesus, pray, my Father, my God, end of year help. Let it come from you into my life. In a lower party or do, or do I get to your door? What's your door, me? But, Mr., the Bible says that the end of a thing is better than the beginning thereof. Only party commander, you better learn. Say, Lord, the year 2020 is ending. End of year help. In a lower, you can see the prayer on your screen there. Pray the number two prayer. Say, Lord, end of year blessings. End of year blessings. Let it come. Let it come. End of year help. Release it unto me. In the mighty name of Jesus. So shall it be for you. I will pray for you. But quickly, jump to number three prayer. Number three prayer. It's on your screen there. Say, Eternal Rock of Ages, hide me and my household under your mighty cover, even as year 2020 is rounding up. In the mighty name of Jesus. Eternal Rock of Ages, hide me and my house. Somebody's just watching, enjoying the broadcast. I'll finish the teaching. Pray. Say, Lord, Eternal Rock of Ages, hide me and my household under your mighty cover, even as year 2020 is rounding up. hide me and my household in me at it. Dile me. Fi wa pamo si abe agbara nla re, abe asia nla re, under your mighty cover. Even as year 2020 is rounding up in the name of Jesus. Father, let it be so. For as many as have prayed that prayer or are praying it, I pray that is, that everything that these people have used their mouth to say in your ears, even on this platform this morning, answer to them, O God. Let it be so unto them. I want to learn more by in sorrow. Your Lord, eje kori bef won, eg ba bef won. In the name of Jesus, quickly jump to number four. Number four, it's on your screen. It's on your screen. Number four, say, my God and my Father, in the name of Jesus, let your blessings find expression in my life. I like to pray for God's blessing every Sunday like this. Say, Lord, my God and my Father, in the name of Jesus, let your blessings find expression in my life and make it evident that you have blessed me indeed in the name of Jesus. Baba mi ati Olorun mi, je ki bukun re ko jeyo ninu aye mi ko han si gbangba. Fi idi re mule kaye ri pe looto looto Olorun ti bukun fun mi, that indeed you have blessed me. Go ahead and talk to God in the mighty name of Jesus. My Father and my God, bless me. Let your blessings find expression in my life and make it evident. Let it be evident indeed that you have blessed me. Thank you, blessed Father. Glory, glory be to your name. We appreciate you, Father. We thank you. I'm praying for you now. Begin to say amen. Begin to type amen. In the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you. Thank you for what the Holy Spirit has done in our lives. Thank you for the work of power, the work of blessings, the work of grace that you did for us and that you are still doing. We appreciate it. In the name of Jesus, on this platform, Gospel Response Ministries platform, on this church online program, this day, I prophesy, everyone that has listened, everyone that will watch the catch up later, Father, pull them under your mighty cover in Jesus' name. I decree, no evil shall fall upon you. It shall not come to your dwelling place, according to Psalm 91 verse 10. In the name of Jesus, as many as have given their lives to you, listening to this, they have received Jesus into their lives and have come to the knowledge, to the understanding that they need to dwell in the secret place of God. I pray you will open your arms, O God. Accept them, receive them, and grant them divine cover in the name of Jesus. For every household, I declare and I prophesy, I decree and I prophesy, it shall be well with you. This December, you will celebrate well. You shall not be filled with sorrow. Pain will not be your portion. No evil will come your dwelling place. In the name of Jesus, the peace of God will reign in your life and in your household. I decree the peace of God, the peace of Jesus, it will reign in your life, your ministry, your church, over your children, over your business, in the name of Jesus. And I bring upon you this morning the dew of heaven, Sunday blessing, let it be your portion. The blessings of worship, let it be your portion. Thank you, blessed Father. We glorify you. You are a good Father. Let these ones, every one of us, receive our daily bread from you. Open your hands unto us, that we may gather. The hands of God is open unto someone. It's open unto a family this morning. I want you to receive it. If you are that family, I want you to receive it. The hand of God is open unto a family this morning. So shall it be. You will gather. You will prosper. You will excel. You will grow. You will grow bigger. And you will be settled. Thank you, Father. It is done. In Jesus' mighty, mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. I want you to accept it. Receive it. Let it sink. Let it go down. Let it digest. You know, swallow it. Say amen. Type amen. Let it become flesh. This word is becoming flesh. Let it live with you. Let it become a portion of your meal today. Thank you, Father. It is so. We bless God. We appreciate Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty, mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. 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 In Jesus' name. Once again, I thank everybody. I appreciate you. You can always send us text message on the WhatsApp number. The WhatsApp number for this broadcast is always with the headline there. You can see it on top. Don't forget to share it with your friends. You can copy the link, send it to as many people as you want. Be a blessing to somebody. All right? I'll meet you again on Thursday, 5 p.m. UK time. The broadcast is always on this page now, Gospel Response Ministries page. But we'll still be sharing it on our personal pages. But always come, always visit this page for live transforming messages. from myself and from different men of God, from different churches, you always find it on this page. It's a page that is open to everybody. Share the page link with people, with your friends, so that they can always come and be blessed here. Okay? And I tell you the truth, the Lord will bless you really good in the mighty name of Jesus. I'm the convener of Gospel Response Ministry, and my name is Kunle Omoshen. I love you too, my brother. God bless you, sir. Thank you very much, brother B. Omoshen. God bless you, sir. I appreciate you. God bless everyone. God bless your family. Happy Sunday. Enjoy the rest of your day. And I wish you a glorious week ahead in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. See you some other time. God bless you.